Jason, I know the outcome wasn't what you wanted, but had to be pleased with the grit that you showed tonight.
Yeah, we're never satisfied with losing, but there are a lot of good things that we can take from this. I thought the energy and effort, guys competed. The bench was really good tonight. But you look at what Hardy did for us starting. We slid Timmy back into his role. He was good for us tonight. But I thought the group fought. We had some good looks there. And then when you hold a team to 20 points, but we only score 19 in the fourth, there's just some tired bodies. And we just try to keep rotating fresh bodies in there. And we just came up short.
You guys fell behind 37 or 19 and 18. Called timeout shortly after that. Is there anything that was said that kind of pulled you guys together? Or what do you think happened from that point on?
Well, I think it's, turnovers were hurting us. We need to get shot attempts, and we just talked about that in the timeout. I thought every three that they shot there in the first 5 or 6 minutes went in, and we needed to take them off the line. But I thought, again, we were moving without the ball. We were setting screens, and sometimes that will take some of the energy away from you on the defensive end. But we had to move bodies. They're one of the best they're the best defense in the league, so we just had to move without the ball and set screens. I thought the group did a really good job, doing that, and hopefully that will be a carryover to Saturday.
What do you see from Tim as far as it just seemed like he was taking good shots, not forcing anything?
Yeah, I thought, coming off the bench, he's back into his role. I thought, again, playing out of the DHOs and being able to get, the split game going, I thought the group did a really good job of setting screens for him, and then I thought he did a really good job of reading the defense, being able to pull up or race the big for a layup. Again, DP setting screens, I thought DP was great, not just the 12 points but the 14 rebounds. But I thought Timmy was that. Again, as I started off, I thought the bench did a really good job.
We talked before the game about Lively, and you mentioned he can't get some fouls. He got his fourth.
Yeah, I mean, that's just bad luck that, he picked up his fourth there. But, the big thing is, he's a rookie. He didn't maybe have his best game tonight, but it's going to happen. But I thought his effort and energy and mindset was in the right place tonight. It's just unfortunate that he got in foul trouble.
What's the biggest difference you saw in Jaden from this start from the last one in Houston? He looked a lot more comfortable.
Yeah, I think, one, we kind of played him off the ball in the sense of having Curry handle and kind of had him in his natural position. And so he was comfortable. He was aggressive. He was making plays. But again, being able to, tell him to look to score, but I thought he also made some great plays for his teammates. And again, playing 30 minutes after not playing last night, he was a positive. And so again, we needed that tonight, and hopefully we can get him in the game on Saturday.
Obviously, it's hard to contain a great player in multiple games, and Edwards said 44 tonight. You guys were effective last game in guarding him. What was working for him tonight that may not have worked last game?
Yeah, I think, one, he had a bad game, so I think he was going to make sure that he didn't have two against us. He was aggressive from the start, and so he's a great player. We talked about that before the game. Shooting the three, getting to the free throw line. When you shoot 18 free throws, that's going to help you get to 40. So he was aggressive tonight. You got to give him credit.
Thanks.
Just settling in, I feel like, for the most part. Settling in to the atmosphere, just making sure that we stay together, stay connected, and give ourselves a chance on the road. So I think we did a great job of that with the guys that were out there playing, and it's always been next man up mentality for the whole season. So we're dealing with a lot of injuries right now, and guys starting to come back. So we're just doing a great job right now, just trying our best to stay connected and go out there and compete.
Thanks.
What did you like about the looks you got tonight? They seemed easy, not forced.
Yeah, I think it was just playing within myself, not doing too much. Guys finding me, just picking and choosing my spots. I don't think I took any wild shots to try to get myself going. I think I, you know, took what the defense gave me and connected on that, which also helped open up driving lanes and passing lanes for my guys to give them the ball and attack and go out there and play basketball.
I've come in on it, obviously, but the grit you guys showed, how pleased were you with
that? Yeah. I think it shows. It showed today, tonight. It kills me to see Ant-Man go 14 for 18, get the free throw line that many times. Free throw lines, us turn the ball over 16. Even though they turned the ball over 22 times, we turned the ball over 16 times. That's not a recipe for success, you know, especially when you have a lot of men out. So. But overall, I think, you know, for the most part, I think we did a great job competing and going out there and giving ourselves a chance.
You mentioned the injuries. The 1-2 Kyrie was a freak injury.
Yeah.
Has that been kind of hard to take when you guys keep playing 11 straight games without him, knowing that what happened to him, like, it basically just not happened?
Yeah, I think that also shows, you know, the leadership and the shows the grit of our team. When one man is out, you know, it's the next man up. And, you know, with Luka's knowing that, Luka's been, you know, carrying the team very well and, you know, putting up huge numbers. So, you know, Kyrie out and a lot of guys out, people would probably think that we would be losing them a lot of these games. But, you know, we're out there competing, like I said. We're out there doing our best to hold the fort and give ourselves a chance and an opportunity, you know. And this is all the bigger picture, you know, down the stretch of the season when close games come, you know, you got these guys that aren't playing that many minutes. They're out here having an opportunity to do so and give us big minutes, being close games, and it's going to help us out big time down the end of the season.
Just coming in and doing some of the little things,
the
cleanup work.
Yeah, I mean, he's a vet. You know, he does that. He does an amazing job of just trying to give us extra possessions, you know, throwing his body around, you know, battling down there. After every game, he has a scratch or he's bleeding somewhere, you know. So he's out there to bang with the bigs and get us open and you know, just do all the little things. So happy that he had an opportunity tonight.
Go ahead, guys.
Yeah, definitely not the outcome we wanted, for sure.
What do you think about the way, though, you guys responded? Pretty short staff.
Yeah, I think we've had a next man up mentality all year, and that's how it has to be in this league. It's a long season. Injury's going to happen. Everybody's got to be ready from, you know, top to the bottom of the roster. So on nights like this, we got to show up with even more, because there's really no excuses.
Tim said that you have a scratch or you're bleeding after every game. Looks like you got hit in the eye. What was it tonight?
Yeah, there's always something, but it's part of the game. I try not to let it distract me, because nobody cares.
Offensive rebounding was something that Cleveland did really well the other night. Tonight, it looked like you were really active there, grabbing a lot of boards. Is that something that you came into hoping to do tonight?
Yeah, I mean, they're obviously a very good rebounding team. They have a lot of size, the 4-5, and a lot of athletic wings crashing. And that was definitely a point of emphasis for us to be physical and put bodies on guys and try to, you know, limit their second chances.
You guys fell behind 37-19. Is there anything specifically said in a huddle or anything that you guys collectively did to kind of turn things around?
I mean, there was nothing specifically said at that specific instance. Maybe to answer your question, I think it was early in the game, and we knew we had things we needed to adjust and things we needed to correct, and there were some
some things that we needed to shore up, and those were discussed for sure. And we knew there was a lot of time left in the game, so it was going to come down to effort and execution, and we still fell short, but I think we did a good job of rebounding, or of like bouncing back from that initial deficit.
You mentioned the injuries and the next game. Why do you think that this team seems able to kind of, it's on some teams it would take a toll. You've been without Kyrie for 11 games, and you guys have kept your head above water. Why do you think you guys have been able to do that?
I mean, I think it definitely still takes a toll. I think it's a part of our responsibility as pros to find a way to still be effective, to step into whatever role that is required of us to help the team win. But that doesn't mean, you know, we don't miss those guys that are out. It's difficult in terms of production, but also these are our teammates and our brothers. To see them, you know, have to deal with those injuries, it's tough, and they do their best to still provide us energy and find ways to help the team even while they're not able to play, and that's important for us. And I think that lends to the next man up mentality, knowing that those guys, they can't contribute on the floor, but they're in our ear all throughout the game and are, you know, in touch constantly, trying to make sure that we're being effective as possible. And yeah, it's not easy for sure. So I think it still takes its toll. But like I said, we can't make excuses.
How much does a game or games like this help, particularly guys that maybe aren't used to being in tight situations down the stretch like that? They're getting an opportunity for big minutes. Could that pay, or should that pay dividends down the road?
I mean, we came up short tonight, so there's a lot of things I think across the board we need to learn from this game and to find ways to, you know, close that gap all the way and you know, maintain for the full duration of the game. But yeah, I mean, there's things to be learned from every situation. Every time we get a chance to step on the floor, there's something to be learned. And whether or not, every time we suit up for a game, there's something to be learned. Whether or not you get on the floor or not, I think we've done a good job as a team of staying engaged regardless of the situation and regardless of your role that night. So I think that lends to our next man up mentality is guys are locked in whether they're playing or not, and they're ready to go because your number could be called at any moment. So I guess to answer your question, at some point we can retrospectively look back and say we've learned something based on some future success, but we still came up short tonight, so there's always something to be learned, and we'll study this film for sure.
Why, for a rookie big, is one of the hardest things how to figure out how to be aggressive and yet stay out of foul trouble? I feel like that's something all rookies deal with at some point.
Yeah, that's definitely a massive challenge, and I would agree that's probably one of the most difficult things. We're asking a lot of D-Live, and he's doing an amazing job, and he's studying the game, and he's bringing energy and effort, and he's impacting the game in a lot of ways on a lot of levels, both offensively and defensively. So we're just encouraging him to be himself and continue to grow in his role and continue to do the things as he's been doing. And he's doing everything in his power to shore up the things that he needs to improve on. That's a big challenge for rookies in this league, but especially centers. So he's doing a good job, I think, of trying to make the adjustments while still being aggressive and impacting the game. But that's definitely a challenge that we've all faced at some point in our career.
Thank you, Clay.